Hello students, in the previous lecture we had discussed singular point and double points. Now you already know about the polar coordinates of a point in two-dimensional plane and their relation with Cartesian coordinate. Now in this lecture we'll continue with the curvature point and define some terms like total curvature, average curvature, this is the center of curvature and radius of curvature, etc., circle of curvature, chord of curvature, etc., and write something for the next lecture. If you understand these definitions properly, then you will find it very easy. You remember the definitions, you find very easy next lectures. Next lecture will become very easy for you. So you have to remember and understand these terms here. Now, let's define what is curvature. Let y is equal to fx is any curve. Y is equal to fx is any curve. And P and Q, y is equal to fx, y is equal to fx. This is any curve in the two-dimensional plane. This two-dimensional plane. Let P and Q be two points, and P and Q be any two point, individual points on the curve given by y is equal to fx. The curve given by y is equal to fx in two-dimensional plane, and P and Q are any two points on the curve. Such that AP is equal to S, arc length, AP is S, and AQ is equal to S plus delta S, S plus delta S. Therefore, PQ is equal to AP minus, AP arc minus APS. So, arc PQ is equal to delta S. Now, let's draw tangent at P and Q. So, tangent at P, let tangent and P and Q makes angle psi and psi plus del psi with the positive direction of x-axis. If they are angle, then compute the figure. Now, this angle is equal to TSR. TSR will be, now if you consider this triangle, TSR triangle, exterior angle is the sum of, you know, we have read in the triangles, exterior, any, if you extend any line of a triangle inside a triangle, exterior angle is the sum of two vertical angles. So this plus this is equal to delta psi, therefore this angle is equal to TSR will be equal to delta psi. Right? So what is this? Now understand the terms very thoroughly. What is this? This is the total curvature or total bending of the arc PQ. So this angle will give us the total bending of this arc PQ. If we divide this total bending by the total length of the arc, that is, we'll get the average curvature or average bending. For tangents, difference angle between two tangents divided by the arc length at the two different points will give the total average bending or average curvature of the point arc PQ. Right? Now, if you want to find the curvature at any point P, so what we'll do? We'll take the limit at delta to zero. We'll bring this point Q to P. So taking the limit, if we take the limit of the average curvature or average bending at any point P, bending or curvature is given at any point P, right? It is denoted by kappa. This is the limit of delta to zero. This is the average curvature or average bending. This is equal to del psi of del s is equal to d0. Right? The radius of curvature at any point. Radius of curvature denoted by rho. Reciprocal of the curvature of at any point is called radius of curvature. the symbol of kappa, one from kappa will give us the radius of the radius at any point P. Radius means ke, if you meet at any point P, we can draw a circle at this, Circle at this point, radius of circle at this point is called the radius of the circle at this point, by touching this curve at this point. Radius that is called radius of the radius. So this will give my the reciprocal of the bending at the point. So z point is the reciprocal of the bending at that point. Right? Now center of curvature. Center of curvature is a distance and center of curvature at any point. So if you draw the circle of curvature at this point, the radius of the circle, the center of the circle is called center of curvature. And radius is called radius circle called radius of curvature at the point, because this center radius and everything changes from point, and will be different for all points on this curve, or can be the same or different. But generally, if the curve is a bending curve is bending, then the radius of curvature, center of curvature, or average curvature, they all depends upon the coordinates of the points, right? If a center of curvature of a curve at any point P on the positive direction of the normal. Positive direction normal will is normal will be. If you don't change it, this normal is upward. The curve towards curve is bending, that's up positive direction. The center of curvature of a curve at any point P on the positive direction of the normal at P, and which is at a distance rho from any point P, which is equal to distance rho, means which is a distance from P at a distance radius of curvature. Right? The circle of curvature of a curve, circle, this is called circle of curvature. Circle of curvature of a curve at any point P is the circle with center C and radius of. Circle of curvature at P is the circle with radius rho and center C. Right? Chord of curvature. Chord of curvature at any point P of a curve is the any chord passing through P. It's called chord of curvature. Right? Chord of curvature of two circle passing through point. So put the point. Point is very important. If you want to discuss anything, the point is very important. Why it is important? Because everything will change from point to the center. Everything will be different for different point in the curve, right? So you have to keep in mind. Now, chord of curvature. Now, let's try an article. Prove that the curvature of a circle is constant and is equal to the reciprocal of radius. Whether curvature of a circle is constant and which is equal to the reciprocal of radius, that is kappa equal to 1/4 not r but kappa radius of radius 1/4. Right? So let's consider circle with center C and radius r or rho. You can take r or rho is equal to R or 1/2. Let's consider the circle with center C and radius R or rho. Let P and Q be any point. Now we are doing it in reverse order. Point is fixed, curve is passing through this point, and we are doing it in any curve. Any point. Now we are discussing this curve. So we have similarly I discussed for the curvature, the curvature or radius curvature. Now we have considered circle here, and the study is similar. Consider a circle with center C and radius R or rho. Let P and Q be any two points on the circumference circle. So PQ, RPQ is del S, that is RPQ is del S. And now again draw tangents at P and Q. So P and Q to the circle such that they make angle psi and del psi with del psi with coordination of x-axis. Now the angle this is psi, again same thing, psi. If you consider angle TSR, X angle is the sum of T is equal to psi plus delta psi equal to this, therefore this looks psi, this minus this is equal to psi. If this is psi, so this will be a good psi. Angle between the lines is equal to, now this is psi, so this angle will be how much? Angle TSQ is equal to pi by minus psi. So now they are normals. QC and PC are normal. Therefore, if it is pi minus psi, therefore this will be psi, because the sum of the, this is 4 pi. So 9 pi by 2, this is equal to angle QCP equal to X, right? So we can also say that angle with the perpendicular equal to angle between the lines equal to angle with the perpendiculars. Same. So this is equal to this, right? Now we angle this, now go to the center, CPQ. Angle CPQ is equal to angle is equal to what? Angle is equal to R perpendiculars. Equal to angle CPQ is equal to R upon RPQ upon DS is R or rho. Okay. So this is equal to del S upon rho or R. So del S upon rho or R. So now take del S to the denominator, take it, convert it to the form of rho. So this is radius of curvature. Where it goes side by del S, yes, 1 upon R, 1 upon rho. Take the limit as del S approaches to 0. This is equal to, taking the limit, del S equals to 0, this will become 0. This is constant, independent of del S. So, limit is equal to, so it will become a psi ds, should kappa is equal to r. Implies curvature at any point P of a circle is the reciprocal of its radius. Radius, therefore, is constant. Now, to conclude, whatever I was saying, radius of curvature at any point of the curve is equal to the radius of circle at the point. So the curvature, whether we write it rho or r, radius of curvature at any point of the curve is equal to the radius of the circle at the point. Thank you.